Lord, praise God, another day of Bible study, worshiping Christ and fellowship on YouTube. Tune in with us and turn along with us as we get into God's holy word. Amen. Praise God for his word. Praise the Lord. Looking forward to tonight. So the title of the message is this: the richness of God's mercy and grace belongs to all of us who call on him by looking to Jesus Christ on a daily with the heart of repentance towards our sin nature.
Amen.
The richness of God's mercy and grace belongs to all of us who call on him by looking to Jesus Christ on a daily with the heart of repentance towards our sin nature. So, it's no respect to persons with God. So the riches of God's mercy and grace belongs to each and every one of us. Amen. And we must understand that it's nothing special that we did to deserve this.
All right.
There's nothing we can do. All we can do is receive what's presented before us in the love of God and sending his precious son, Jesus Christ, down the cross for our sins and rise from the dead for our justification, amen. That's what we must do in order to be saved. Praise God. Have a heart of repentance towards us and Israel's most religious on a daily. So I'm going to go to the points real quick and then we're going to go to the word. Number one is this: when it comes to the richness of God's mercy and grace, because of Jesus Christ coming as God in the flesh and dying on the cross for our sins, for the sins of all of mankind, and rising from the dead for our justification, no one is ever excluded. No one is ever excluded unless they reject the love of God by rejecting his son, Jesus Christ. The only way someone is excluded is if they reject the love of God by rejecting Jesus Christ, meaning not receiving him into their heart as the Holy Spirit touches on them. And as we receive in the heart, that means we have a heart of repentance. We don't say that we receive Christ and still live the same way we were living. Because the Holy Spirit will correct us.
Yeah,
once we do that, then he'll correct us and lead us to repent. Amen? That's how it works. So it's not like we can still be in the same mindset once we receive Christ and say, oh, I received Christ, but I'm just going to do me. I'm still going to live in a fornicating relationship. I'm still going to be homosexual. I'm still going to be a liar. I'm still going to be caught up in materialism, self-righteousness, pride, arrogance, you know, whatever the case may be, jealousy, anger, unforgiveness in heart. I'm still going to go turn up and drug and do whatever I want to do, but I receive Christ. No, we struggle with these things. We're going to struggle with these things, keeping it 100 with you. But we cannot say we receive Christ and stay in those things and say that it's okay with God. That's all God is saying to me.
Right.
That's what it means to receive Christ. Number two, God is no respecter of persons. He wants all souls with him in his holy, eternal kingdom in heaven at his judgment. But if we are not looking to Jesus Christ on a daily with the heart of repentance towards our sin nature on a daily, by being Holy Spirit led and not fleshly driven, we will be in danger of the lake of fire in his judgment. And that's real talk right there. It's not no game, you feel me? We'll be in danger of the lake of fire to judgment. If we think that we can live this life and just do what we please and live how we want and say, I love you, Jesus, go to church, shout, fall out, speak in tongues, prophesy, all the stuff the New Age Church promotes, the New Age Church, Pharisaic, self-righteous tradition, and men's system promotes those things, but they don't promote looking to Christ alone. Which is what we need to promote, is the gospel of Jesus Christ, looking to Christ alone. If we don't look to Jesus Christ alone with the heart of peace for our sin nature, we will be in danger of the lake of fire. That's just real talk.
Amen.
It's not about being perfect. It's not about not. It's nowhere about making mistakes. It's not about that. It's about looking to Jesus Christ. Paul said, this one thing I do. Get those things which are behind.
Yeah.
But I reach to those things which are before me.
Yes, yes.
I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling in Christ Jesus. Praise God. So let's go to Romans 10, 9 through 13. Look what the word says. Romans 10, 9 through 13. We're good on time. Romans 10, 9 through 13. Let's go there quickly. Get this in. The riches of God's mercy and grace belong to all of us who call on him are looking to Jesus Christ on the day with the heart of repentance toward our sin nature. So just be encouraged on today knowing that. But we're going to see, like I said, calling on Him is not just saying, Lord Jesus, it's a heart to receive Him. Amen.
Yeah.
So Romans 10. Romans 10:9-13, real quickly, praise God. So, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. See, people stop right there.
Yeah,
but let's keep going here.
Yeah.
For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness.
Righteousness.
See, when it says believe in our heart, we're believing unto righteousness. I mean, we're invoking Jesus Christ as the one and only true living God. We have a heart of repentance. We're being led by the Holy Spirit. It's not just when it says, thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thy heart. When believing in our heart means that we believe unto righteousness.
Right.
The righteousness of God through Jesus Christ. And with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation.
See?
So with our mouth, the word of our testimony. We're going to read in Revelations. Revelations 12 and 11, we're gonna read that it tells us that right there. It says, we overcame Satan by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. We loved our lives unto death, meaning we don't value our physical life or our spiritual life in Christ. So that's how we overcome. So verse 11, for the scripture says, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. For there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him.
Okay.
James said, the riches of God, mercy, and grace belongs to all of us.
Yeah.
He's rich to all that call upon him. See, when we call on him, it means for us to look to Jesus Christ on a day with the heart of repentance toward our sin nature. That's what it means for us to call on him. Amen. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be what? Saved. So whoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. When we say we call on the name of the Lord, this is not just yelling out Jesus or shouting hallelujah or saying thank you, Jesus, when you wake me up. No, when we call on the name of the Lord, that means for us to look to Jesus Christ on the day with the heart of repentance toward our sin nature, allowing the Holy Spirit to lead us and not being fleshly driven. That's what it means. So let's go to Romans 2:11 real quick. Real quickly here. It says, watch this. For there is no respect of persons with God. So we see that. There's no respect of persons with God. So God's not singling anyone out here. There's no chosen people. You're chosen. You're the true Israelite. They got a group called the Hebrew Israelites. The black Hebrew Israelites. You black people are the true Israelites. All people of color. Hey, God has no respect for persons who ever call on the Lord. The riches of God's mercy and grace belongs to all of us who call on Him by looking to Jesus Christ on the day with the heart of repentance through our sin nature. Doesn't matter about race. Doesn't matter about class. Doesn't matter about denomination. Doesn't matter about spiritual gifts.
Nope.
Speaking in tongue process doesn't matter about that. Whoever call on Him. God's going to manifest Himself, His Holy Spirit, and all flesh through those gifts. In our life, but that doesn't mean that a person is saved because they have those gifts, prophecy and speaking in tongues. Doesn't mean that. We read Matthew 7. Tells us that. So let's go to Acts 2:17-21. And it shall come to pass in the last days, says God, I'll pour out my spirit upon what? All flesh. It's Holy Spirit. No respect to persons. Gonna pour out Holy Spirit upon all flesh. No respect to persons. Amen. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. So you're looking at me funny, because the way I dress, my hair color a certain way, and I don't look like I should be spreading the gospel. Then he says he's going to pour out his spirit upon all flesh. Don't look at how people look. Look at what's being told and the truth of the word. If it's lined up with the gospel of Jesus Christ in its entirety, look to that.
Amen.
Look to the truth. Right away from the New Age church, self-righteous tradition of men, Pharisaic system. We got to get away from that thinking.
Yes.
And just look to Jesus Christ. And it says, And all my servants and all my handmaids are pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. His spirit, Holy Spirit. Yes. Okay? And I will show wonders in heaven above, and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood, before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass, this is key, that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord, what? Shall be saved. Call on the name of the Lord, shall be saved. Whosoever shall call on Jesus Christ, shall be saved. What does it mean to call on the Lord? What does it mean to call on God? Call on Jesus Christ. By looking to Jesus Christ on the day with the heart of repentance towards our sin nature. That's what it means to call on Him. See, then the Holy Spirit can lead us into carrying out God's perfect will for our life. Doesn't mean we'll be perfect. We'll make a ton of mistakes along the way. I do myself. Keep it at 100. It's not about perfection in church, being churchy. I'm talking now. It's not about being churchy. It's not about getting dressed up on Sunday and looking good and just trying to show yourself to be holy just because you dress a certain way or you talk a certain way or a certain degree you have. This ain't about none of that. It's not about none of that. We're going to make a bunch of mistakes along the way. We're not perfect. This is about looking to Christ and trusting in Him alone. And He's going to help us through. Amen. Carrying out God's perfect will for our life. So let's go to the main point. Revelation, we talked about Revelation already. Revelation 12:11 says what? And we overcame Him. We overcame Satan. Revelation 12:11. By the blood of the Lamb. How we overcome Him? By the blood of the Lamb. By the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the word of our testimony, and we love not our lives unto death. We don't value our physical life over our spiritual life in Christ. So we're looking to Christ, who is the author and finisher of our faith. Main point, the mercy and grace of God which He has shown all mankind through Jesus Christ coming as God in the flesh and dying on the cross for our sins and rising from the dead for our justification is so powerful that it never runs out. Look, it never runs out, but watch this. Until the day we die, or until Jesus Christ returns. So, when we die, the whole point of the matter is the richness of God's mercy and grace is bestowed upon us in Jesus Christ. So, the whole point of the matter is when we die, it's no more. We can't say, if we haven't received Christ as our Lord and Savior, when we died in our sin, that's run out. We can't repent now. So if Jesus Christ comes, returns before we die, and we have received Christ in our heart as our Lord and Savior, with the heart of repentance to our sin nature, then once Christ gathered up His elect, it's no more Holy Spirit on earth. It's no more grace. It's over. It's no more. He's not coming back again. Read Matthew 24 and explain that. He's not coming back again. Once He gathered up His elect, it's over. I know there's a lot of false prophets and false teachers talking about it. Oh, He's going to gather people up. Then you have another chance after He gathered and left them. It doesn't line up with Scripture. Keeping it 100 with you. Once Christ comes, the mercy and grace of God is running out because He took His elect. And now, the people who are left here, which you have taken the mark, or worship the image of the beast, will get the wrath of God upon them. There's no more mercy and grace after that. So, we must understand. His grace doesn't run out. Until we die, until Christ returns. Says, God's all-powerful, miraculous mercy and grace gives us total victory over sin's destructive power controlling our lives so we can carry out God's perfect will for our life. So, we must understand this. The riches of God's mercy and grace belongs to all of us who call on Him by looking to Jesus Christ on a day with the heart of repentance towards our sin nature. Understand that God is no respect of persons, and you have the victory by the mercy and grace of Christ, and you must call on Him. Look to Jesus Christ on a daily with the heart of repentance towards sin nature, and you will be in the will of God for your life. Trust in Him alone. God bless you. Amen.